Back to piss on my corpse, you ungrateful little... who are you two?
We're looking for a whetstone. Have you seen it?
Aye, there was one in this room.
Pair of pasty feefools, you sure can't fight. I'll give you that.
Well,
we found no whetstone. This dagger belongs to the Reaver who took it.
They took most of the good stuff.
Oh? dagger you brought me is quite interesting. An artless design, but the construction is sound. Where in the temple did you find this?
In a reaver's back.
Oh. Oh.
He mentioned he was part of a larger clan. Maybe they took the whetstone?
Quite possibly. I know I've seen this design before.
Atreus, follow me.
Tell us the story of the giant that stole Thor's hammer.
Happily, my boy. It involves your friend Freya, too, though I don't expect it's one she'd enjoy being reminded of. The giant was called Thrym. And he proved cunning enough to make off with Mjolnir while the thunder lummox slept. Sadly for Thrym, he didn't always think with his brain. But I can just tell you the story later.
Bofar.
Are you okay?
No, hell what? I was there.
The thunderstorm scattered all three of my ships across the lake.
Boy. Discovered opportunities for hunting and trade in these lands. I gave up my search for Jotunheim long ago. Leave that for the younger, more hopeful men. But I was overeager. And my men paid a heavy price. Bones pulse with magic.
It must be Golvi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
His spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
Well?
Well, what?
The brazier?
If you must.
Kvekja.
Oh!
Well done, boys. Never thought I'd...
What do you want?
To thank you.
See you, Dad.
Indeed.
Have you seen...
Only...
Useless.
Well, we can't expect them all to know something useful.
Wolver, behind you, brother!
Mom were here.
I felt blessed to lead such a loyal crew. We'd become a family.
Maybe the next one will have more information.
Keep your expectations low, boy. Spirits are rarely useful.
How do they even exist?
When you sever a man from his life, it is not always a clean cut.
So you've met other spirits?
Yes. Many.
What were they like?
Annoying.
In the middle of a story, weren't we? Thrym, the cunning frost giant king, had stolen Mjolnir while Thor slept. Though he had robbed the greatest giant killer of his greatest weapon, he offered to trade it back to the Aesir in exchange for Freya as his bride. And we'll pick this up later.
climb these stairs. Language disk.
Right then, where were we?
Ah, yes. Thrym the Cunning stole Thor's hammer and ill-advisedly offered to trade it for Freya's hand in marriage. Now, at this point, Freya was married to Odin, and Odin, frankly, would have traded her for a sufficiently strong mead, but he saw an opportunity here. Thrym's palace was in Jotunheim, and only giants know the way. By agreeing to the marriage, they'd have to escort Freya back to their realm. Or I can just tell you the story later.
We're not getting in there without a key.
Right then, where were we?
Ah, yes. Thrym the Cunning sought to ransom Thor's stolen hammer for Freya's hand, presenting Odin with a rare opportunity. So, Odin coerced Freya into using her Saether magics to conceal Thor, so he could sneak along with her and infiltrate Jotunheim. When the hammer was produced as the wedding dowry, Thor revealed himself. He took back Mjolnir and wasted no time in smashing Thrym's skull, followed by every other giant present for the festivities. The only thing that put a stop to it was Freya. She wanted no part of this massacre. She cast a powerful spell that hurtled them both out of Jotunheim with no means of return. Odin was livid, hoping that Thor's foothold in Jotunheim would become his own. You know what? I'll tell this one.
Govig's bones.
What will you say to her?
To Govig?
Your mother. What have you left unsaid?
I just want to know if she's okay.
She is dead, boy.
I know that. You don't understand.
Neither do you.
It's another one of those maps. What would you? you say to Mother?
Nothing.
Nothing?
There is nothing left to say.
What about everything we've done so far? That man coming to the house? Talking to the world serpent? We've done so many amazing things. I just want to tell her about them. Don't you?
What else would you say to her?
I tell her that we're both okay. Not to worry about it.
Atreus, I miss her too. You know this.
I thought I did very little. We're almost done with that story.
Ah, yes. Thor's massacre at the wedding of Grim the Cunning was finally put to a halt by our friend Freya. And oh, did he ever revenge himself upon Freya.
What is the point of this story, Ed?
Well, for Thrym, the lesson would be to keep his priorities straight. For Freya, it's that doing good has a price. For Thor, it's that no object of power makes you what you are. And if what you are is the biggest butchering bastard in the Nine Realms, nobody can...
The ogre's hurt! Yeah.
wasn't so bad.
Oh.
have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Ganungagap, the great void. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced. Or I can just tell you the story later.
Look here.
Yes, sir. More of those. Good. Another name. Air!
It's as if they've been made into a memorial to the Valkyries.
I have a thing. Do you remember the dagger you gave me?
The dagger stabbed into the Reaver's back? His own son killed him? Yeah.
Well.
Wait, no, yes, yes, come in.
Another treasure hunt?
Well, don't buy anything on my account.
Well, not if Sindri really can make us better equipment with that whetstone. Plus, the Reaver's son, he murdered his father. This is it, right? The Rockstall?
Aye, lad. The Council of Valkyries.
The Valkyries are of Valhalla, are they not?
Glad to see you're paying attention, brother. You are correct. Valhalla, the Great Hall of the Einherjar, is their home within Asgard. But while there, they are subject to the scrutiny of the Allfather himself. And relations between the Valkyries and Odin were tense during my tenure as his advisor.
Why?
Well, that's an even longer story, lad. For now, why don't we look around for some clues? Gunnar, Mistress of War. After any conflict, big or small, she would be first on the scene, sussing out the worthy spirits for a free trip to Valhalla. A gruesome task, but she took great pride in it.
Any conflict?
This is Rota, a chooser of the slain.
I thought all the Valkyrie did that.
Not exactly, lad. Although that is what they're most famous for, and by far their greatest responsibility. You've seen what happens to the dead without the judgment of the Valkyries.
Fellwalkers.
That's right. Rota, Gunnar, Skuld. Without them to clean up the aftermath of battle, hell overflows with souls meant for Valhalla. A sorry state of affairs. Rota must be beside herself.
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
Right then, we were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Regarding Ymir. Primordial fire and ice met in the great void, producing water. And we'll pick this up later.
Ready yourself, boy!
Scattered around these beaches.
She was too pure, beautiful, too. They are searching for you, Gulvig. You will soon show them the power.
Right then, we were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Regarding Ymir. Primordial fire and ice met in the great void, producing water.
Water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. From Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. Called himself All-Father, as if he was the creator and not the creator's destroyer. The slob, covetous tyrant.
Ymir?
Huh? Oh, sorry, my boy. You know, I think it best we just end it there, actually.
Can we dock on this beach?
Final bone.
Yeah.
We might as well return them to the spirit. Maybe he will keep his word.
I know she's not coming back, okay? I know. I just... never mind. I just got right here.
Apple doesn't fall far.
Piece of the language cipher. Good.
Ah, Fafnir. I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Fafnir's storeroom, Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Hey, lads!
How did your friend become a dragon, Mimir?
Oh, he's no friend of mine. His little throat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and
Vanir.
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Dwarf come dragon.
Never answer the boy's question, Ed. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
Go for certain, though I'd wager his intention for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.